Well friends, this is our English period and we are going to learn one of the best lesson of our curriculum, that is the hack driver. If you like to listen stories, it is one kind of story and it is a detective story. Many times we like suspense story where we find the mystery, that like story we like. This is one kind of story where we find certain suspense, certain mystery, and you will enjoy it. I'm sure you will enjoy this lesson. Okay, so most of the time, I want to ask you something. You have been deceived by someone else, and after deceiving, how you have felt? Surely we become so nervous. Oh my God, how fool I was when somebody was deceiving me. So same thing happened with the narrator of the story, who is lawyer, who is very innocent lawyer, and he is very straightforward man and very innocent and simple person, and who got deceived by one of the very professional person, professional we can say criminal. That story we are going to learn in this lesson. The name of the lesson is The Hack Driver. If we see the narrator, or we can say the author of the story is Sinclair Lewis, who is American novelist who has first, he is the first winner of, he won the Nobel Prize for the Literature. He is the first novelist who won the Nobel Prize for the Literature. He is a son of a country doctor, and he was at the initially, he was very introvert person, and he was very intelligent as well. So this kind of person he was, and he has written a very nice story which we are going to learn today. So while learning this story, while learning this lesson, we are going to go with this Bill. Bill is a character who, we'll see that afterward, but actually he is a Oliver Lutkin. These four places I have mentioned here. First one is Frizz. He plays poker. Poker, you know, poker is a game which we play with the cards, you know, playing cards, and we get some money also in that. Then second, Gustav, he's a barber and he used to go there. Then pool room and Lutkin's house. These four places we are going to see in this whole lesson. So basically this lesson is very interesting because there is certain climax also, because when we see any movie, we don't want very plain movie, we want certain climax, some, you know, magical thing should happen, then only we enjoy. Like that, this lesson is also very, will surely satisfy you. Okay, we'll see that. What is the introduction is given here? A young lawyer comes to a village to serve summons on Oliver Lutkin. Summons means, you know, to call. Okay, call by the, legally we have to call for one of the cases. So that is called the summon. Okay, invitation is different. When we invite someone, it is very humble, but this is very strict. Someone is very strict. A friendly hack driver takes him round the village in search of the Lutkin. Does he find him, and who is the Lutkin? That we are going to learn. So in this lesson, as I told you that it's very interesting lesson, it's very mysterious lesson that we will learn, and we will enjoy this lesson as well. So after graduating with honors, I became a junior assistant clerk in a magnificent law firm. And now narrator, this lawyer is narrating this story, narrating his incident of his life. So we can say it is a real account. Okay, so after graduating with the honors, when we graduate, we do something, we complete one level of education, graduation means. And he has completed with the honors. I became a junior assistant clerk in the magnificent, very well-known, reputed law firm. I was sent not to prepare legal briefs. Actually, one person who becomes a lawyer has to do something, some of the work which is related to some of the cases or lawyer, you know, law in court, like that. But he was a clerk in that office. But what was his job? To serve summons, like a chief private detective. And he has to go and he has to work as a detective there. I had to go to the dirty and shadow corners of the city to seek out my victims. And I have to call those victims there. And you know that victims, criminals are not living in a very, you know, luxurious place, or we can say will not get very easily. For that, we have to go in a corner of the city somewhere which is dirty place where nobody can go like that. There he has to go to call them. Samadhi means to call. Some of the larger and more self-confident ones even beat me up. And when he used to go there, he has to face many, you know, very harsh situations also. Some victims have beat him as well. I had a this unpleasant work and the side of the city, it revealed to me. And actually his opinion, his image of the city was very different, very brilliant. He was thinking that city life is very, very luxurious. We have to go there and I will enjoy this. But when he go to catch the criminals, that time he found that this life is not that good. He got the true picture of the city when he used to go for the summons to the criminals. I even considered fleeing to my hometown, and he was totally agitated, we can say, or he was very, very nervous, disappointed with the work, and that is why he wanted to run away to his hometown, where I could have been a real lawyer right away. And he doesn't want to play the role of the clerk in the that magnificent firm, but he wanted to go to his village, his hometown, and be directly lawyer. No need to go with the training period. And without going through this unpleasant training period, because you know training period is always unpleasant, because you have to learn many things, you have to go through, and many things which are unfamiliar to you, and you have to learn it, and many times we have to pay the price for it also. So I rejoiced one day when they sent me out 40 miles in the country, and I was away around 40 miles, and I was told to go to the village country, to a town called New Million, to serve summons on a man called Oliver Lutkin. We needed this man as a witness in a law case, and he had ignored all our letters. And why he has to go? Because you know that from the court many letters have been sent, but he hasn't arrived there, he hasn't come there, and he has ignored those all letters. That is why he went there. They have told this lawyer to go and call him for the case. When I got to the New Mullion, my eager expectations of sweet and simple country village were severely disappointed. And when he went there, that he was thinking that this village life will be very simple and very happy, and that is why he wanted to go there. And he went there with a very happy mood, but when he actually entered in the village, he found that his all expectations were totally disappointed. Its streets were rivers of mud, and can you walk on the road where you will found only and only mud? So he found that, and that is why he was very nervous. With the rows of the wooden shops either painted a sour brown or bare of any paint at all. The only agreeable sight about the place was the delivery man at the station, and one person was there, and that was the only good thing he found in this New Million city. He was about 40, red-faced, cheerful, and thick about the middle. And this was his description. He was about 40 years old. He was red-faced and very cheerful, very happy-go person. His working clothes were dirty and well-worn, and he had friendly manners. And very important thing was that he was having friendly manners. You felt at once that he liked people. And when you see that, when lawyer saw him, he find that he has a friendly manner and he liked people. Like that his appearance was, his attitude was. I told him to find a man named Oliver Lutkin, and he said, I want you here. Because I want that, I want you to go around the city, around the village. Lutkin, I saw him around here about an hour, sorry. I want to, to find a man named Oliver Lutkin. He said that I want to see the person, I want to search the person, that is Lutkin. Lutkin, I saw him around here about an hour ago. Hard fellow to catch though, always up to something or others. He is probably trying to start up a poker game in the back of his shop. And he said that that I want to find out the person Lutkin. And as soon as he said that Lutkin, he, that person who was standing there, he was a delivery man, he said, Lutkin, oh, I saw him around here about an hour ago. Hard fellow, and he just started here describing him, hard fellow to catch though, always up to something or others. He's very, very different person and he's involved in many matters. He's probably trying to start up a poker game. As I told you, poker game is a game related to, you know, playing cards and winning some money, winning some cash amount like that. He's probably trying to start up a poker game in the back of priest shop. It is illegal game. Okay, fine. I shall tell you, boy, is there any hurry about locating Lutkin? Is there any hurry? Are you in emergency to court, catch him? Yes, I want to catch the afternoon train back to the city. I was very important and secret about him. And I have made much important work with him and very secret as well. Because, you know, when anything which is related to any, you know, any criminal, it's very secret. We should not reveal it in front of anyone else. So, I shall tell you what. I have got a hack. I shall get it out and we can drive around together and find Lutkin. So I have cart also, I have a hack. Hack means one, you know, vehicle which connected by the horses. So I can help you in, you know, searching the Lutkins. He said, I know most of the places he go, he hangs out. And as I know him, I always see him going here and there. So I know many places where he used to visit regularly. So I can be helpful to you. He was so open and friendly that I glowed with the warmth of his affection. And you know that suppose you are a stranger in one of the city and if you go there and somebody who doesn't know you but you know, behave with a very friendly manner, then you feel very happy. The same thing happened with the lawyer. He was very happy with the nature of this person. And he was very, you know, easy to he was very easy to mingle with any other person, and he was very happy, and he was very helpful person to lawyer. I knew, of course, that he wanted to business, but this kind of was real. I was glad the fair money would go to this good fellow, and you know that he was a very, very affectionate boy and person. And he thought that, okay, if I will give some fair money to this person, I will be very happy because this is a very good person. And you know that suppose we give certain amount or certain good things to any other person who is looking good and who is really honest and sincere, we feel very happy. Okay, my money will not go waste. Like that feeling we have. A similar thing, kind of opinion of this lawyer as well. I managed to bargain down to $2 an hour. And then he bought from his house nearby sort of large black box on wheels. He remarked, well, young man, here is the carriage. And then he brought one box, black box, to sit on the carriage. And he said, okay, this is the carriage. And his wide smile made me into an old friend. And he had given very good smile, wide smile, very big smile. And that I remember my friend. And I was very, you know, quite comfortable with him. And I found that he is my friend now. These villagers are so ready to help a stranger, and he has made up his mind about the villagers. Village peoples are very, very good. They are really ready to help to any stranger. If you go to city life, you know that very well. The city life, the people lives in the city or live in the city. They always very introverted. They don't speak with others. Even what is happening in the nearby house, they don't have any worry about that. So, but in the village, something will happen, all people will come together, they will resolve the problem, they will find some solutions for that, like that. So that he was having certain great opinion about the villagers, very positive, optimistic opinion about the people of the village. He had already made it his own task to find Oliver Lutkin for me, and just see, he was there to find the Lutkin, and he is helping without any inquiry, without any work. He said, okay, I will help you to find the Lutkin. He said, I don't want to interfere, young fellow, but my guess is that you want to collect some money from Lutkins. So he started asking some question about the Lutkins. I guess, I don't want to interfere in your matter, but I feel that, I guess that you want to collect money from Lutkins because he said he has certain prime information about the Lutkin that he might have taken money from the people, and that is why he had come to ask for the money. He never pays anybody a cent, and he is just trying to tell him, the lawyer, that he never gives money to anyone. He still owes me 50 cents on a poker game. I was fool enough to play with him. As I told you about the poker, poker is a game which is related to, you know, playing cards and earning money, earning cash amount. And he said that I had played with him one game, that is poker, and still he has to give me around 50 cents. And he hasn't given, and I was fool, because I knew him very well that he will not give me money back. But then too, I played with him. He's not really bad, but it's hard to make him part with his money. Actually, the person-wise is very good, but when matter comes for the money, he is very, very different. He's very bad in that money. He never give money to anyone. Like that he said, if you try to collect from him in those fancy clothes, he will be suspicious and get away from you. And suppose you want to search this Lutkin, then it is quite impossible for you, because when he see you in these comfortable and luxurious dresses or fancy dress, he will go away from you. So better that you should be go away from him, and just we will find something in a different way. So if you want, I will go to fridge and ask for him, and you can keep out of sight behind me. So see, just see, this is the first place where he wanted to go to find the Lutkin. So he said that, what, we will go to first fridge, where he plays the poker. So there I will go first, and you just hide behind me. So that what will happen, he will not recognize, and he will be there, and you will catch him very quickly. So, I loved him for this by myself. I might never have found Lutkin. Because of this statement, because of this behavior, I loved him very much. Because by myself, I cannot catch the Lutkin. Lawyer acknowledged this. With the hack driver's knowing help, I was sure of getting the man by my hand. And so, this sort of man will help me, and surely with the help of this man, I will catch this man. Otherwise, I would not have caught this person by my own. I took him into my confidence and told him that I wanted to serve the summons on Lutkin, and that the man had refused to be a witness when his information would have quickly settled our case. The driver listened earnestly. At the end, he hit me on the shoulder and laughed. Well, we will give brother Lutkin a little surprise. And then now he found that quite a reliable person. Lawyer found that he's a reliable person. So he said that, okay, I want this Lutkin for the one of the case, for the point of view of one of the case. And if he will come there, then we can settle down the case. And many times we have sent a summons, but he ignored those. And that is why I am here. And this driver listened it very, very carefully, and he hit on the shoulder of the lawyer and laughed. Well, we will give brother Lutkin a little surprise. Let's start, driver. Most folk around here call me Bill or Magnuson. So he said, he introduced himself, I'm Bill. Most of the people of this village called me Bill or the Magnuson. My business is called Williams Magnuson's Fancy Carting and Hacking. I'm doing this business, fancy carting and hacking. Hacking means I have hack means one of the vehicle, and I roam around the city with the people. All right, Bill, shall we proceed to fridge? Okay then, okay, fine, good. We'll proceed to fridge, where I will get the this person, that is Oliver Lutkin. Yes, Lutkin is just, Lutkin is just as like to be there as anywhere. Plays a lot of poker, he is good at deceiving people. Bill seemed to admire Lutkin's talent for the dishonesty. Now Bill is trying to talk about Lutkin, about his talent in deceiving people. Actually, this is not the admiration. This is what about? He's telling about him in how bad he was actually. But he has great knowledge about him. I feel that if he had been a policeman, he would have caught Lutkin respectfully and chided him with the regret. So, at the time when he was talking about Lutkin, that time lawyer has thought that, okay, suppose he would have been police, he would have caught that Lutkin and would have kept in the jail with a regret. He thought like that. Bell led me into the fridge. Have you seen Oliver Lutkin around today? Friend of his looking for him, said Bill cheerily. And now they went to the fridge shop where poker, this game had been played by the many people. And then this Bill went to the that fridge house, and he asked, have you found Bill here? And that at a time, that lawyer was behind the Bill. Fridge, look at me, hiding behind Bill. He hesitated and then admitted, yes, he was in here a little while ago. Guesses he is gone over to Gustav to get a shave there. So he said that he was there. Lutkin was here a few minutes ago, few moments ago, but right now he is not here. He went to, maybe he might be at the Gustav. Gustav is another, with the barber, and he might have gone there to have shave. Well, if he comes in, tell him I'm looking for him, he said like that. We drove to the Gustav barber shop. Again, Bill went in first, and I lingered at the door. He asked not only the shaved, but two customers if they had seen Lutkin. The shaved had not. He said angrily, I haven't seen him. I don't care to. But if you find him, you can just collect that dollar 35 he owes me. And he said, when he go to Gustav, that time that Gustav didn't say anything, he was very angry. And he said that if you find, I have not seen him here, but if you found him, then tell him that he has to give me $35 to me. One of the customers thought he had seen Lutkins walking to, down the main street, this side of the hotel. And one of the customers said, okay, I have seen him walking on the main street near the hotel. As we climbed back into the thack, Bill concluded that since Lutkin had exhausted his credit at Gustav, he had probably gone to Grace for a shave. So he was going to Gustav for the shaving, but many times he hadn't given money to Gustav. That is why he might have changed the place. That is why he might have gone to this place, Grace Barber Shop. We missed Lutkin by only 5 minutes, and when they reached there, so there also they have got the information that before 5 minutes he was here, now he has not been there. He had just left, probably for the pool room. At the pool room, he appeared that he had just bought a pack of cigarette and gone out. So we pursued him just behind him, but never catching him for an hour till it was fast 1 o'clock. And they were just trying to, they got the information he had just purchased cigarette here and just went from here. So they remain unsuccessful to catch him, and they were just traveling around the village till 1 o'clock. It was around 1 o'clock, for an hour till it was past 1 o'clock. I was hungry, but I had so enjoyed Bill's rough country opinions about his neighbors, and scarcely cared whether I found Lutkins or not. So that time he was just searching here. Main aim was there to find a Lutkin, but he didn't. But he enjoyed the company of the Bill. How about something to eat? I suggested. Let's go to the restaurant, and I will buy you lunch. He said that, okay, now I'm hungry, so how about going for lunch? Well, I ought to go home to the wife. I don't care much for these restaurant. Only 4 of them, and they are all bad. And he said that in the village, 4 are there, 4 restaurants are there, but all 4 are bad. So better we will go to our house and tell you what we'll do. Then we'll get the wife to pack up the lunch for us. My wife will pack lunch for us, and she won't charge you more than $0.50, and it would cost you more for a greasy meal in the restaurant. So if we'll go to our house, my house, and my wife will pack lunch for both of us, and it will cost around $0.50, so which is quite cheap for both of us, and we'll go to the hill and we will have that lunch, he said. So we will go up the Wade's Hill and enjoy the view while we eat, that he said. So we have seen in this lesson, first of all, we have seen the information about the author, that is Sinclair Lewis. He is American, first American novelist who won the Nobel Prize of Literature for the literature. He's son of a tree doctor and he's very introverted and very intelligent. Then we have seen the person in the lesson, Bill, who is a delivery man. And when lawyer has gone there that time, he was very friendly with him. And then when lawyer said about his why he has come here, his aim to come in this village, that time he said that I have to catch Lutkin for one of the case. And then this Bill has taken him to many places like a fridge where he plays poker, then Gustav where barber, and then pool room, and then they both become very hungry. That is why they wanted to go there. And that time he said that okay, there are four restaurants in the village, but all four are very bad. So well, we will go to my house. My wife will pack a lunch for both of us, and it will cost around half a dollar. So if it will not be, it will be very cheap, and we'll go to the hill and we'll enjoy the lunch. So till you might have understood the lesson, and next part of the lesson we'll see in the next video. So till then, thank you very much.